First, they were lost at sea on the other side of the world while a local woman waited. Thanks for staying with us here at 5:30. I'm Todd McDermott.
And I'm Tiffany Kenny. Now the mother of the ship's captain is opening up to us, saying that she believes she will never see her loved ones again. Ari Hait spoke with this woman who was determined during this interview not to get choked up. Right, Ari?
Yeah, she certainly was. I talked to Carol Dyke last week. At the time, she was still hoping for the best, still praying for a miracle. Well, when I talked to her again today, this was a very different Carol Dyke. This one has now given up hope and believes she will never see her son or his family ever again.
But did you know that now you're on TV?
Carol Dyke has been spending a lot of time lately with her pet dove, Jeremiah.
You need an animal at the worst moments to cuddle with.
And this is definitely the worst moment. The West Palm Beach woman now believes her son David and his family died at sea.
Good morning, America. This is David Dyke on the Schooner Nina.
David, his wife, and their 17-year-old son had been sailing around the world on the Nina, an 85-year-old wooden schooner. They left New Zealand on May 29th, headed for Australia. They hit heavy storms and vanished.
All the power was lost on the Nina. They had no radio. They had no engine at work.
A month-long search, nothing. New Zealand officials have now announced they've stopped looking. That announcement comes as they discovered a text message from the boat sent June 4th that was never delivered. It said, "Storm sails shredded last night, now bare poles."
I think they were caught in that very bad storm, and the last thing anybody heard was the Nina had lost its sails.
Dyke had been holding out hope, praying for a miracle. But after seeing that text and after no sign of life for a month, that hope is gone.
She was trying to keep a stiff upper lip and a smile.
Trying to smile, but not always being successful. Carol told me that one thing has been uplifting her throughout this whole thing is that her church has put out the word and she's been getting prayers from people all over the country. She says that makes her feel humbled and honored. Reporting live in the news from Ari Hait, WPBF 25 News.